This YCN segment is brought to you by New London Hospital, an affiliate of Dartmouth Hitchcock.
Welcome in, YCN Sports Talk, Jeremy Stout, and this week joining me is Rob Taylor, Executive Director of the Lebanon Area Chamber of Commerce. Rob, thanks for joining me, and it couldn't be a better day. First one after the Red Sox win.
I lucked out on the assignments. This is a great week to be a Red Sox fan.
Exactly, and obviously you're a big Red Sox fan lifelong, as well as I am. So before we get into it, you know, obviously everyone knows they beat the Dodgers 4-1. Just your initial reactions. I mean, this team from the beginning of the season to the end of the season, one of the best teams, one of the most fun teams to watch all year.
It was an absolute pleasure to be a Red Sox fan this season. I think, you know, arguably you could make the case that it was probably the best season ever for any Red Sox team. I mean, 108 wins in the regular season, plus all the playoff wins. And of course, the quality of the opponents that they beat in the playoffs,
right,
from the Yankees to the Astros to the Dodgers, all you know, elite teams with elite pitching. Boy, just, you know, the theme of the season was kind of passing the baton. They seemed to have whoever was the next man up. And it was, mm-hmm, you know, obviously we have superstars and JD and Mookie and others, but just role players that really sort of, I think, made the difference for them this year.
Right, and one of those role players we'll talk about right now, the MVP of the World Series, Steve Pearce. And what a story he was from the first, you know, time when they got him. He was killing the Yankees in the regular season, hitting home runs, and part of that big sweep, four-game sweep, and then it rolled all the way to the playoffs. And what an unlikely hero, but a guy who, when you put him in the right position, now he doesn't have to lead the team, he can be good.
Yeah, he was one of those role players. He coming in for Moreland to pull up the slack. And, of course, he ended up winning the MVP in the World Series with a bunch of clutch home runs. But really kind of a neat story. I looked him up a little bit on Wiki. And, you know, he actually has the distinction of having played for all of the
American League East teams. Yep.
And, you know, bounced around the league. You know, great ball player. He actually had some neat connections to the Boston area. His dad, I think, mm-hmm, was originally from the area. So he grew up a Red Sox fan.
Right.
It's just a really neat story. And that's one of the neat things I like about baseball, is it really can be something special like that to sort of pop up in the postseason and make a huge difference.
Right, yeah. I mean, there's 25 guys on a roster for a reason, and everybody has their own roles. And as you mentioned, a big Red Sox fan. I think he was actually drafted by the Red Sox, but then he went back to college. And you're right, he grew up in Florida, but a big Red Sox fan. And he was always rooting for the Red Sox, even though, you know, he'd been on all the different teams. His family was a Red Sox fan. So it was one of those things that was a really good story. And that brings us to another really good story. I think it's a really good story. David Price, just the way he finished his postseason, obviously with a big win, but three straight starts that were amazing. Going back to that Houston Astros series, he struggles in this game against the Yankees, game against the Astros, and then he finishes it with a bang. Does that finally maybe put away to rest everything he's done in the postseason up to that point?
I think so. I think he got the monkey off his back. You know, that was his one sort of blemish on his career, was his postseason prowess. And, you know, convincingly, with at least the last three starts,
right,
really putting on a clinic and really coming through clutch. Alex Cora used him in some key situations for some key outs. But actually just today, he made the announcement to Red Sox faithful at Fenway Park before they jumped on the duck boats that he will be staying in Fenway and continuing to pitch. I don't think it was ever really a doubt. He's making boatloads of money.
Right.
Sure, he could make boatloads elsewhere.
Right.
But why would you want to leave the confines of friendly Fenway Park and a team that really, I think, is stacked for future success? So not a real big news story. I think he'd been intimating all along that he wanted to stay. But he made it official today that he's not exercising any options to become a free agent. He's going to stick it out till the end of his contract. He's going to make $127 million amount.
So. Right, 4 years, $120-plus million. And plus, like you said, there's a lot of team left. So we're going to talk about in the next segment, you know, there might be some free agents should they sign. Who are the guys they need to look forward to? But obviously, if you've got Price coming back, you still got Sale. The Red Sox picked up his option. That was a no-brainer. Price, Porcello, maybe they sign Eovaldi. We'll talk about that. Should they re-sign Eovaldi? Maybe Steve Pearce. Where do they go in the offseason? And where does it stack up in the list of the other three Red Sox championships of recent memories? I mean, there's been four championships since 2004. Where does that stack up? So we'll talk to Rob about that when we come back. You're watching YCN Sports Talk.